Poppy, you ready?
I am so ready.
Okay, Poppy, you know, we say 3, 2, 1, hit it. So you ready?
Of course.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1, hit it!
Not dead. just wanna be sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord of my soul to keep. I just wanna be sheep, ba 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 ba. I don't wanna be a Pharisee.
No way.
I don't wanna be a Pharisee.
No way.
'Cause they're not there, you see. I don't wanna be a Pharisee. 'Cause I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord of my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. Oh, I don't wanna be a hypocrite.
No way.
Oh, I don't wanna be a hypocrite.
No way.
'Cause they're not hip with it. I don't wanna be a hypocrite. 'Cause I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord of my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. Well, I don't wanna be a Sadducee. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba.
Nice job. Nice job.
High five. Oh, yeah. Nice job. You guys are good. Oh, yeah.
That was so much fun.
Wasn't that? You know, I think their favorites is the sheep one, honestly.
That's my favorite, too.
That was awesome, wasn't it?
No.
That's not your favorite?
No.
You know, my favorite one is the Jesus is King, because you get to do this. Right?
That's awesome.
Okay, I did forget one thing. So everybody turn around and say hi to the live stream.
Hello. Hi, live stream.
I almost forgot to say hi to them. So we're so glad you worshiped with us. All right. So everybody, go ahead and take a seat. We're going to pray and let preschool get out of here. Yes, we'll do that right after they leave. All right. Hands together, eyes closed. Dear Jesus, we thank you for today. We ask that you just bless kids' church and preschool and big church, and that we just get to hear from you today. And bless the rest of this day. In your name, amen.
Amen.
All right, preschool, line it up.
Bye, preschool.
Bye. See you later, preschool.
Bye, preschool.
We love you, preschool. Goodbye. Farewell. Hey, guess what, Poppy? I found my keys.
You found your keys?
I lost them today. I found them.
I can't believe you lost your keys. Where did you find them?
Right where I left them on the table. I said I lost
this
them on a
table.
Counter somewhere. I said I lost them on a counter somewhere. I don't know which counter it is. Well, it happened to be this counter right here. The table counter. All right. I need somebody to help me with the kids' church prayer for offering. You want to do it? All right. Come on up. All right. Let's hear what she says.
Dear God, please bless this offering.
Amen. Nice job. All right, if you guys have offering, we have the guys' bucket over here and the girls' bucket over there. Woo, look at these ladies getting up. Nice job. Oh, and we have some boys. Liam, how's it going? Long time no see. He doesn't know I'm talking to him. Okay, this is heavy. You just gotta take a marble out of there because I can't lift it. And then come put it over here. Oh, yeah. Hi, Mia. I saw you when you walked in and I was gonna yell your name. But then I saw your dad and I hadn't seen your dad either. And then he was closer. So, Yes, if it is your first time, you get to put a marble in the marble jar. Thank you, Maddie. All right, if you are here for the first time, you know what? Ella, what if Miss Katia did it for you? You want to have her put a marble in for you? Once we fill this up, hey, what happens when we fill this up, guys?
You get, well, kids' church party!
Kids' church party! Yeah, come on over. All right, I also see some Bibles, so if you guys brought your Bible, go ahead and put a marble in the jar for your Bibles. That is awesome. Nice job. Oh, Cohen, nice job, Cohen, bringing your Bible to church. Thank you, Riley. Ooh, nice job, Cohen. All right, and our last one is, if any of you said the memory verse before we get started with the memory verse. Anybody?
Wait.
Yeah? You know what it is?
I'm getting started.
Okay. All right, you know what? It's okay, because you know what? Our verse is still new. So, Poppy, if you didn't know this, we actually have a brand new verse that we started last week that we're going to start today. I'm going to move this out of your eyeball. There you go.
Oh, thank you. Yes, it's very hard to see.
Yes, I thought so. Okay, so can everybody come as forward as you can without getting on my stage? I said without getting on my stage. All right, as close as you can so leaders can pull out the risers. And we're going to get started on this memory verse. All right, come on. Well, careful. Come on over here. Thank you, thank you. Yes, let me move this around. There we go. All right. Okay, if I get anything wrong, feel free to correct me. I'm going to do my best. So we're going to talk about how our verse is, how you made me is amazing and wonderful. I praise you for that. What you have done is wonderful. I know that very well. Psalms 139:14. All right, you guys ready? So we're going to talk about how you made me. So who made us?
God.
So we're going to point up to him. How you made me is amazing. Let me see your jazz hands. Oh, yeah, let's see him. Nice job. Okay. Is amazing and wonderful. Okay. Hey, careful, your neighbor. All right, here we go. How you made me. Okay, whoa, whoa, whoa. I can't be the only one talking here. Ready? How you made me is amazing and wonderful. Good job. You have the first part down. All right, is I praise you. We're going to raise the roof a little bit. Oh, yeah,
raise the roof.
All right, I praise you for, oh, wait, we got to do the little golf thing. For that, let's see, what does it say? What you, so who are we talking about again?
God.
God, not me, God, what you have done, because we're talking about him creating, right? So we're like pretending like playing Play-Doh right now without touching your neighbor, Cedar. Thank you. All right, what you have done is wonderful. I know that very well. All right, you guys. All right, best karate move without hitting your neighbor. Pasong. Pasong. Does anybody know what we did for 139:14?
139:14.
Football boys. You guys like football boys? All right, I'm gonna do it. Ready? Okay, here we go. 139:14. Oh, you guys want to do a little competition? Who can go lower? All right, here we go. Right, my turn, then your turn. Ready? 139:14. Oh, okay. I can go lower. 139:14. 139:14. Okay, I think I got one more of me. Hang on. 139:14. Okay, you guys are good. I don't know if I can go any lower than that. All right. Last one all together. How you. Okay. Here we go. How you. Okay, people. Louder than me. How you made me is amazing and wonderful. I praise you for that. What you have done is wonderful. I know that very well. Psalm 139:14. You guys are good. All right, go find your seats. Yes.
Do you want me to get any water for you and Poppy?
You know, I'm okay right now, actually. I got my drink right here. But thank you.
Bobby, you want any water?
No, I'm good, thank you.
All right. Go ahead and find a seat that is not going to be next to somebody who's going to be too distracting, or maybe you might become the distraction. Sometimes that happens, right? Sometimes we distract our friends. Let me just adjust this because I got to keep what time it is. It's 10 o'clock. All right. 10 o'clock! 2 hours ago! Well, according to that clock, it was like almost 3 hours ago. But that clock's wrong, so don't look at it. All right, so how many of you know what we talked about last week? Anybody? Should I give you a hint?
Creation.
Correct. Some of my first service people are still here. Shh, don't give all my answers out. Okay? If you were here, hang on. If you were here at first service, you guys cannot give out my answers. Okay? Because that's not fair to second service. They got to work for it, man. All right. And if you're online, you can type in your answers. And Mr. David will tell us if they typed anything in. And we'll see. All right. So we talked about creation last week. Somebody said that. Now someone might have already also given you the next answer. What is the first book of the Bible?
Genesis.
Genesis. All right. Okay. So we're going to talk about Genesis, where we talked about creation, right? Now, what do you think comes after creation?
Adam and Eve.
Shh. You're no longer allowed to answer. He was here for service. He knows all my answers. All right. Adam and Eve, right? So we just talked about creation. We talked about how God created everything, right? He created. What do we know that he created? Hands. 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 Cedar, what's something he created? The world, but what's something in the world that he created?
Us.
Us, right? What's something else?
He created animals.
Shh. By hands. The what? Grass and the universe.
The temple.
The temple. He made us, such as the temple, to take care of. So, yes. All right, Benjamin, what else?
So, he created wars.
Probably
how humans create wars.
Can I give you some hints?
Yeah.
Something in the sky.
Clouds.
Yeah, good job.
Birds.
Mia? Plants. Jocelyn?
The sun?
Noah? Birds, not airplanes.
Animals,
right? All right, I'll take one last one right here, Ella.
Food.
Yes, he did. Plants. There's food on plants.
Adam and Eve.
Right? Somebody already said Adam and Eve. But, so he created this, right? Sun, stars, sky, water, darkness, light, right? All of this we talked about last week. Poppy, what are you doing over there, huh? All right, Poppy.
Yes.
Question for you. The kids already answered this, but let's see if you were paying attention. What's the first book of the Bible?
Genesis.
Oh, she's good. And what's something that God created?
He created animals.
Well, what's your favorite animal?
That's a good question.
Do you have one?
Maybe a snowy owl.
Oh, a snowy owl. I like that. All right, so we know that God created everything, right? So we're going to continue on with that today. Now, okay, I want everybody to close your eyes. Okay, Poppy, that includes you too. All right, so close your eyes. She's putting her head down. That's her way of closing them. Okay, I want you to think of a time that you built something. It could have been something really cool, or it could have been something that you worked really, really hard on. Online, think about this too. You can even type it in if you want. Think about, it could have been with your toys, it could have been a drawing, a Play-Doh, just something that you created yourself, okay? All right, now open your eyes up and raise your hand and tell me what you had. Summer.
One time I made this really cool Lego house.
Oh, yeah? I'm not super talented with Legos, so anybody who is, I think that's awesome.
Diamond art.
Diamond art? Okay, I don't want to tell you. I've always wanted to do that. Is it really hard?
Yes.
Yeah, that's cool. Whoa, that would be a lot of patience, huh? You and your brother what? Oh, okay, okay. See, you guys are good. You guys are good at stuff. All right, Ethan.
Lego Star Warship.
Maddie, what about you?
Treehouse.
A treehouse? That's cool. All right, Benjamin. Whoa.
We're homeless. We have to build in the wild.
Oh, you're building in the house? That's pretty cool that you have to build a house from scratch.
We do have cars.
Yeah.
So we take an off-road vehicle down to our tents and we get in that to get to our car.
That's really cool.
And then my dad works, so he drives that down. And
yeah.
He drives it up and then my grandpa.
So you guys are building a house. That's pretty awesome. I think that's really, really cool. All right, last one.
I think Lego Star Wars is
pretty fast. Oh, like a rock? Oh, that's cool. Okay, so now what I want you to imagine, so think about it, and actually, you know what? Go ahead and tell your neighbor real fast. Tell your neighbor something that you built really cool. I'll give you guys like 30 seconds to tell them. All right, Poppy, what's something that you have built that was really cool or you worked really hard on too?
Well, I once built this Harry Potter Lego set, but I built it on a table so it fell and broke.
Oh, no. Okay, okay. Hey, all right, voices down, voices down. All right, good job. All right, wrap up what you just told your neighbor. Good job, good job. All right, Poppy said she built a Harry Potter Lego set. Is that what you said?
Yes.
But you broke it?
Yes, I built it on a table, which shook, and it fell over.
That's so sad. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. I rebuilt it.
Oh, that's good. Well, okay, so you rebuilt it, right?
Yeah.
So, okay, I want you guys to think about this. What you guys just told your neighbor, or what you guys were just thinking about, how many of you have siblings? Oh, quite a few of you. I have siblings too. And Poppy, do you have any siblings?
I do.
Oh yeah, you have your sister that was here not that long ago.
Yes, I do.
Okay. So, all right. Now imagine that your sibling or a friend, if you don't have a sibling, came over and they were going to play with you with it. But instead of playing with you with it, they destroyed it. How would that make you feel? Huh? Imagine you worked really hard on your diamond set picture. Right, Harper? You're right. Imagine you worked really hard on your diamond set and someone just came over and like flung it and all the diamonds went everywhere. How would that make you feel? Sad and mad, right? How about your guys' Lego sets, right? I came over and just Hulk smashed them. How would that make you feel? You worked really hard on your Lego Star Wars ship thingy, mabobber, and I just came over and went, boosh. What do you think? Or your treehouse, right? I don't know if I can actually destroy a treehouse. I'm not that strong. Lincoln?
My grandpa Daryl, he built an owl log and he carved it.
Oh, that's cool. All right, so imagine that your toy, your drawing, your artwork, whatever it may be, just got totally demolished and destroyed by your sibling or your friend. Well, yes, but think of something else that's not has crystals inside of it. How would it make you feel?
What if he glued it back together?
No pretty crystals. Yeah, how about that? What if he glued it and he said, nope, sorry, you don't get to see what's inside of it? How would that make you feel? Mad, that's right. All right, so give me your mad face. Let me see your mad face. Like, you're just angry. Yes. Okay, so the reason I'm asking you about this is because something similar happened. To God. right? He created, right? We just learned about creation. He made all these beautiful things. But then Adam and Eve came into the picture, and something else came into the picture. You guys know? Lincoln?
The python.
The snake, right? Yeah. Came. And then, well, do you guys know what happened next?
Yeah, they ate from the tree of knowledge.
Oh, yes. Which brought sin into the world, right? And destroyed what God had made beautiful, right? So we're gonna listen to this. So what I want you guys to do is, I want everybody to have your hands either tucked underneath you or onto your side. And I want your eyes closed. Because we're doing Wonder World. Because we're doing Wonder World, we have a little audio for you guys to listen to with it, okay? So Poppy, I want you to do the same thing, okay?
Okay.
We're gonna listen to what, we're gonna amuse our imagination, okay? So no talking. You're just gonna imagine with your eyes closed what they're gonna tell you to imagine, okay? All right, so go ahead and close your eyes, and we're gonna listen.
In the Bible, in the book of Genesis, God created the whole world and everything in it. Picture yourself flying over the earth God just created. Look down. What do you see? What does it feel like to be soaring through the air? Now imagine yourself landing in the middle of the most amazing garden ever. Imagine all the things you would see and hear and smell. Picture yourself touching the different plants. Look at all of the different trees with fruit on them. Now imagine that there's a river running right through the middle of it. That garden you just landed in, it's called the Garden of Eden. It's a place that God created for Adam and Eve to live in, and it was pretty out of this world cool. The best part about the garden is that God spent time with Adam and Eve there. God had a special relationship with Adam and Eve and took care of them. Can you believe that? Imagine what it must have been like to actually walk and talk with God in the garden. What do you think God's voice sounds like? Life was perfect in the garden. No one ever got sick or died. No one was ever mean. Everyone told the truth. It's kind of hard, but can you imagine how you would feel in a place like that? There was just one rule in the garden. God told Adam and Eve, "You can eat the fruit of any tree that is in this garden, except for one. It's the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat from it, you will surely die." Imagine this tree in the middle of the garden. Was it bigger than the others? The Bible doesn't say what kind of fruit was on the tree. What do you think the fruit looked like? The Bible says in Genesis chapter 3 that Satan slithered up to Eve in the form of a snake. Imagine the snake saying to Eve, "Did God really say you can't eat the fruit from the tree of knowledge?" And then the snake lied to Eve. "If you eat from the tree of knowledge, you won't die. In fact, you'll become just like God." Picture in your mind Eve reaching up and picking one of the special fruits from the tree of knowledge. The Bible says that Eve couldn't resist, so she took a big bite. Can you hear the sound of Eve biting into the fruit? What do you think it tasted like? Was it good? After she had some, she gave it to Adam, and he ate some too. And then they felt something they had never felt before. They felt ashamed. They got that sick feeling in their stomach you get when you know you've done something really wrong. Just then, they heard God walking into the garden. Adam and Eve did something else they had never done before. They hid from God. Imagine Adam and Eve quickly hiding in the garden. What do you think they hid behind? God pretended he didn't know where they were and called out to them, "Where are you?" Adam came out of hiding and said to God, "I heard you in the garden. I was afraid, so I hid." God already knew about their terrible choice, and he knew things would never be the same. Along with the sin came sickness and death. But there was something even worse. The sin wrecked their perfect relationship with God. Picture a giant wall separating God from Adam and Eve. That wall is just like sin. It separates us from God. But here's the really amazing part. Even though people totally wrecked God's perfect world with their sin, God kept on loving us. Can you imagine that?
Wow. So, they said, they were walking in the garden. Now, there were some of the things they asked you to imagine. Now, one of them was they had you imagine what it would be like with only telling the truth, with only good. Poppy, how would you feel being in a place like that?
It would be so peaceful.
Peaceful? How would you guys feel?
Your eyebrows.
Huh?
Your eyebrows.
Oh,
no.
Yeah. I'll fix your eyebrow.
Here. It has a mind of its own sometimes.
I'm just going to, there you go. You know, I'm going to make it into a heart.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
Now.
Oh, thank you.
All right. So she said peaceful. How would you guys feel being in a place like that, Lincoln? Yeah, you would feel kind of like them if you did what they did. Yeah, I agree with that. Now they said the Bible doesn't say what kind of fruit was eaten, right? So, what did you guys imagine? Summer? Hey, what? Hands. Summer? An apple tree. Okay, Mia, what did you imagine? A grape tree. Yum, I like grapes. Kinsley?
A pear.
Hair. Tyler?
A dragon fruit,
a natural dragon fruit. All right, Maddie? What kind of fruit did you imagine? What's your favorite fruit? Carrots, yum.
Carrots are not fruits.
It's right, but well, that's what she chose in her garden. Benjamin? Golden pear tree. All right, last one, Lincoln.
I would just imagine if there was like a plum tree.
A plum tree. Ooh. All right. Poppy, what did you say again?
I said a nectarine.
Oh, a nectarine.
Yes.
Ooh, those are good. I'd have to say, I think I'd have to go with apple tree because I really like apples. They're pretty good. Oh, yeah, a star fruit? Ooh, that's a good idea. All right, so here's my next question. What was your favorite thing while listening to that to imagine? Benjamin?
What I heard of the bad thing that they did was eating that fruit, they could die past a few. In a few weeks, they could die.
Well, I don't know about that. So what the Bible was saying was that God told them not to eat from that one, right? He said, you guys could have anything in here except for this tree of knowledge, right? But then what came along?
Satan.
A snake? Psst. Oh, I don't know. What does a snake sound like? Psst. Right?
Satan.
Yes, which is Satan, yes. Right? And he said, you should eat this apple. This is going to give you all the knowledge. And did they fall for it? Yes, they did. Right? And what, Poppy, do you know what they felt afterwards?
Guilty.
Guilty, right? Lincoln said it earlier. Feel ashamed, right? Now, they sinned, so you guys know what their consequences were? Does anybody remember what their consequences were for sinning? Huh? Well, they weren't going to be able to live forever, right? So they did have, eventually, they were going to have to work really hard. So there wasn't heaven exactly, it was the Garden of Eden. So that you were correct, though, they had to leave, right? They weren't allowed to stay in there anymore. And in fact, actually, they said that they're going to have to start working really hard for what they're earning, right? And there's a couple other things, right? So it wasn't just like, okay, you made a mistake, move on, right? No, they had to have consequences. How many of you guys get in trouble at home and unfortunately you have to have a consequence, right? I'll tell you, growing up, I did some things, right? I sometimes wouldn't listen to my parents, and one time I said a bad word, and I had to brush my teeth out with soap. That was ugh. So I learned not to say bad words anymore. And did you ever pick on your siblings? Right? I did that. I got sent to my room a few times for that one. But you know what I did? I actually asked my parents for forgiveness, and I apologized to them. Right? And I apologized to my siblings for being mean to them, too, because that wasn't very nice. Right? So that's what I'm talking about is, actually, I have an example for you guys, so we're going to see. Poppy, I got something right next to you I'm actually going to take, okay?
Okay.
So just don't mind me. All right. So when we talk about sin, it's called missing the mark, okay? So when we mess up, yes, that's where it was. So when we mess up, we sin, right? And sometimes we miss the mark. Who here thinks that they have, like, really good aim? Let's see here. Let's see.
I don't know about you guys, but I have excellent aim.
Oh, do you?
I do.
Guess what? So do I.
I'm hiding now.
I'm sorry, Poppy. I won't do it anymore. I'm so sorry.
Never coming out again.
Let me see here.
Been scarred.
Hudson, coming up. You think he can do it?
Who called me Tootsie?
Right. Have you ever shot one of these before?
That's my sister's name.
Okay, well, he might need a little help here. Okay.
Okay.
All right, so you're going to take that.
I'll come back.
Use this and
aim
it right at those. You got it?
I'm stuck.
Whoa. Hang on, let's try it again.
All right. Okay, I'm back.
Oh, closer. Hang on, go ahead and leave those right there for me. Oh, thank you. All right, I'll give you one more shot. All right. Oh, hang on. All right. Oh, you're so close. Nice job. Nice try. All right, who thinks that they can? Is somebody else? Let's have a girl give it a shot. Let's see here. Mia, come on up, Mia. Oh, thank you.
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 7.
She's 7 years old. Thank you.
You're 12.
All right, Mia.
Shouldn't you be in middle school?
You can come a little closer, right here. All right, you know how to shoot one of these? Okay, you can use this to aim. What's your favorite color? Don't shoot at the boys, though. Oh, it's ready, I think. Yeah. Let's see. Whoa! Nice shot. Okay, you get 2 more shots. Okay. All right. Woo! She is so close. That's some pretty good aim you got there.
Wait, where's the...
Oh, hang on. There you go. Oh, nice try. Nice try. Whoa. Hey. I don't know where it went. I'm not sure. All right. Okay. All right. Oh, thank you. Okay. How many think you got? I can do it. You guys think I can do it? I mean, I got Poppy. Let's see. Oh, dear.
No, you didn't hit me. You missed me.
Oh, yeah? Oh!
You said you'd never do it again.
I'm sorry. I couldn't resist, Poppy. I'm so sorry.
If you were sorry, you wouldn't have shot me.
Go ahead and give those to me. It's actually a Nerf one. All right. If you guys have it. Whoa.
Take your ball back.
Thank you. You know what? If you guys hand them to me and don't throw them at me, that would be awesome. Just hand them. Okay.
Yes.
What's your favorite animal?
Okay. Thank you. All right.
A snowy owl.
Poppy, what's your favorite color?
Pink.
Oh. Pink's my favorite color. Okay. So, hang on. Everybody clap once. Clap twice. 3 times. 1 time. Half clap. Oh. Okay. You know, in your small groups, you guys will have an opportunity to play something very similar, okay? So don't worry. But I have a drawing for you guys, okay? Because we talked about missing the mark, right? So the bullseye is our mark. That's what we were shooting for, right? Now imagine if I told you that Mia and Hudson, because they missed, they sinned. They just sinned right now. Wow, how dare you? Right? How would that make you feel?
Sad.
Right? You're like, what? What's going on? I didn't sin. Well, the reason I'm saying that is because when we miss the mark, when we miss our bullseye, right, it's sinning. And you'll actually, Noah, hang on, buddy. It actually will say that in the Bible. I just lost my train of thought. Miss the target, right? So, if missing the target is sin, what is hitting the bullseye? What's something, Cedar?
Forgiveness,
I like that. Let's put that on there. Forgiveness. Let's see if I can spell these all correctly. What do you think, Antonio? Yeah. Caring. What time are we?
10:25.
Yeah. What time next service starts at 11? Okay, we're good. I had to think of what time I had. Okay. Coffee time. Yeah. Coffee time's real. Ladies, what do you think? What's something else on here? We got forgiveness, we got caring. That looks like a
family.
There we go. Sharing? Sharing is caring.
Being kind.
Oh, thank you, Poppy. Being kind.
You're smart, Poppy.
She is.
I know, I'm smart.
All right, Summer.
Giving.
Maybe you can do my math for me.
Sorry. No, you have to do your own homework.
Maybe she can help you, huh? Ethan. Love. I love that. You like that? Noah. Helping. I like that. We have any other ones? Maybe two more? Mia?
Careful.
Wait, did you say careful? Being careful? You know, I'm not the world's best speller, I must admit. I'm so sorry. Okay, last one. One more. Benjamin.
I think we should go for hugs.
Hugs? I like hugs. We have caring on there. Nice job. You guys came up with some really good ones. All right. So now let's imagine this. Okay. Right here is, this is hitting the mark, right? Over here is missing the mark. I'm going to give you guys a couple of examples, and I want you guys to tell me which side of the room I should go on, okay? So this is hitting the mark. This one's missing the mark. Okay? All right. First one up is, I'm at home with my siblings, and my parents aren't around, and he won't give me the toy, so I push him and take it.
Oh,
I'm over here?
Mark.
Okay, I'm over here. Okay. You know what? My friend was being bullied, so I punched the bully.
Oh, missing the mark.
Over here. Well, you know, it was a trick question. It was a trick question because you guys think that maybe it would be a good thing, but should we ever use violence? No. So it's missing the mark. All right. Let me think here. You know, my sibling was told to pick up all her toys, and I did all mine, so I decided to help him out a little bit. Over here? Oh, over here, okay. Over here, that's good. I just got my favorite ice cream. I got like a whole thing of it, and I decided to share it with my family. Over here? Okay. My friend really hurt my feelings, and I told her that I forgave her when she apologized. Okay. One more? Okay. My parents said to go clean up my room, but I was almost done my video game. I was so close. And I said, okay, I'll do it in a minute. So I just kept playing video games. I decided not to listen to my parents and kept playing video games. Right? We should listen to our parents, right?
Yeah, listen to parents.
Yes, exactly. Okay, so you guys get the idea, all right? Now, I have a verse for you guys. Hang on. All right, I have a verse for you guys, okay? So let's throw up that verse real fast. It says, give thanks to the Lord because he is good. His faithful love continues forever. So who are we giving thanks to?
God!
Yes, to God and Jesus. Why? Do you know why we're giving him thanks?
Because they take care of us and their gift is for forever, to live forever.
Well, we live forever with him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It says his faithful love continues forever. Okay, now, this might be a little confusing to some of you because we're like, well, they made a mistake, right? And sometimes when you make mistakes, does it feel like maybe you can't be forgiven if you make too big of a mistake?
Yeah.
Right? Oh, okay. Go tell the leader over there. I got you. But the truth is that we can actually be forgiven. When we ask for forgiveness, God says he will forgive us, right? And Adam and Eve, right? Let's talk about them. They sinned, right? But God still told them that he loved them. And actually, this verse right here says so. It says, he is good. His faithful love continues forever. And how do we know that God still loves us even though we make mistakes? Do we, if I made a bunch of mistakes today and I asked for forgiveness, am I going to get forgiven?
Yes.
Right? All the time. Right? God will always forgive us, no matter how tiny the mistake is to how big the mistake is. If we apologize and ask for forgiveness, he says he's going to forgive us. Right? And that's how God shows his love to us, right? Who did he send to die on the cross for our sins?
Jesus.
Right? His son. Hey, ladies. So he sent his son to die on the cross for our sins. That's a lot of love, right? And that's what he's saying. His faithful love is going to continue forever because he's always going to forgive us. Now, I have one last piece I want to say is sometimes we aim for this right here, right? We aim for caring, we aim for sharing, forgiveness, kindness, helping others, loving, but sometimes it's really hard, right? How many of you find it hard to love your siblings all the time, right? How many of you find it hard to share your new, brand new favorite toy that you just got, right? How many of you find it hard to share your giant chocolate piece of cake that you just got, right? Right? Poppy, okay over there?
Yes.
All right.
I accidentally kicked the microphone.
Oh, Poppy, what is? Do you ever find it hard to share with your little sister?
I do.
I
just want everything for myself sometimes.
Yes, right? It's really hard. But guess what? Hang on, I got one last thing. Hang on, everyone, clap twice. All right, clap once. Okay. The last point of this is that even though it's really hard to reach that, who's gonna help us? God is going to help us, right? And sometimes that means we need to pray about it, right? And ask God to help us and guide us in being caring and being giving and helping others and loving and forgiving, right? And sometimes it's hard. And that's when we go to God. And we're going to talk a little bit more about this in our small groups.